where I finally found the one spot on this chart that said yes, testosterone was covered. It had to be testosterone supionate to a specific kind of testosterone. And so I found it. So I was like, okay, so the testosterone's covered. It looks like there's a $10, $15 copay. So I'm set. So I was like, okay, I can get the testosterone. Now I have to figure out, like, you know, how do I get it? You know, who starts that? Like, you know, can my primary care physician start me on it? Or do I have to get referred somewhere else? You know, an endocrinologist, do they write the referral or do they write the prescription? So, and what was that process like? And so I called the insurance company, and the agent who picked up the phone was not helpful at all, and she didn't want to help. It seems like she didn't want to be helpful, and it felt like there's some stigmatization going on. And I hung up the phone. I was just really upset. And I don't mind saying this on YouTube, but I had a really long cry after that conversation. Just everything came out, like, it just felt unfair that I shouldn't have to do this much digging, that people should be willing to help me, and I wish I wasn't trans, and I just wanted to all go away. And it just all came out right then and there for a good 5 to 10 minutes. But anyway, after that, I can compose myself afterwards. I was like, okay, Mel, how are you gonna find this, figure this stuff out? And I was like, you know, I probably just got a really crappy agent on the phone. And I bet if I call back, I'll get someone who's willing to help me. And that's exactly what happened. I found a woman who was really helpful, answered all my questions. I figured out what the process was. My doctor would write a prescription, and they would call this number and it would be all good. It wasn't clear as to whether a primary care physician does this or an endocrinologist. From what I heard, the primary care physician could write the referral or write the prescription. But anyway, I figured out what I needed. And so then I had to find a trans-friendly doctor, which is no small order. And that was difficult. And if it wasn't for the fact that I was so keyed into the community here, you know, I would have been out of luck. Finding a trans-friendly doctor, finding a therapist, and also, like, finding the therapist I found, by the way, she had only written one letter before for surgery. So she really, it was really a learning process for both of us. You know, I had to learn about the Harry Benjamin standards of care, which is sort of the medical framework we have to work within if we want to start testosterone or start hormones or seek surgery, gender-affirming surgery, whatever you want to call it. So I learned about that, and it was a process for her. I was also looking for information about how hormones work. And so I sought to understand the endocrine system, and I learned all sorts of information about what hormones do, how they work, the risks that were associated with testosterone, with hormone therapy, what blood tests were involved and what would they be measuring in those blood tests and why. And so then there's also, once I got the testosterone, how do I inject myself? Because, I mean, I did a test shot in the doctor's office, but that doctor's visit was like a week before I actually injected myself for the first time. And, you know, I forget stuff. I mean, I don't know, you know, tomorrow from yesterday half the time. Well, that's not true. But, so yeah, just trying to find information on that. And I ended up asking a friend to come over. But there are all these, like, little things along the process of transitioning, these information needs, and it's not always accessible, and it's really frustrating. And one of the things, like, I'm hearing from the people I've been interviewing for this project is, like, you know, just this feeling of being overwhelmed, and it really is overwhelming. It's a lot of work being trans, and it was overwhelming for me, despite the fact that, again, I'm keyed into this community that was basically handed to me on a silver platter, and being in a place that is so, not necessarily trans-friendly, but aware of the needs of the transgender population. You know, I go to a school that has gender-neutral bathrooms, and gender identity is a protected category in its non-discrimination policy, and there's even a preferred name policy at the school where you can go by your preferred name as opposed to your legal name, and that's shared across the university. So, you know, it's a pretty cool place with a lot of resources. And, you know, and I'm in, I mean, school studying information science, and if I can't be like, if this stuff isn't easy for me to figure out, you know, if it isn't easy for me to navigate all these resources, then, you know, there's a problem here. So anyway, that's what sparked my interest in doing this project, just thinking that there's got to be a better way to do this, to find this information. There's got to be a way to find this information. There's got to be something like either healthcare professionals or information professionals can do differently in sort of meeting the needs of this population and getting them information, instead of putting this huge burden on us. And especially, like, I'm not even from here, so I don't even know what, I didn't even know what was here, what was around, what resources were here. As of now, there's been only one study about the information needs of transgendered people. And the person who did the study wasn't really explicit about her demographics as far as gender identity was concerned, like whether these were trans men or trans women or something else or whatever. But looking at the results, it just seemed like they were mostly trans women and male cross-dressers. And they really didn't get at the medical needs or information needs of these people. So I'm trying to fill this gap. And so healthcare professionals and information professionals, librarians included in that, know what we need to know and can make it easier for us to get that information. So yeah, I'm talking on and on and on about this paper instead of actually writing the damn thing, but anyway, that's what I've been up to.